were curious about the waste we create during our school lunches. With nearly 1,000 students eating, we wanted to take a closer look at what we sent to the landfill, recycling center, and compost.
Here are some things we've noticed. A lot of students don't spend time actually eating their lunch. This results in a large amount of food waste. Students who buy lunch from the cafeteria are also required to grab a fruit and a vegetable in order to promote healthy eating, but that results in food waste too.
At a majority of other elementary schools in our district, the students sort their own garbage. Here at Hill, our custodians take student lunches for them. And because they're in a hurry, a lot of the waste doesn't get sorted properly. Food waste and plastic end up in the garbage.
We decided to get our hands dirty and conduct a waste audit to calculate all of the lunch waste we create in one day. During our eco audit, we realized we were sending unnecessary waste to the landfill.
We have plastic reusable trays, but the lunch staff continues to serve on styrofoam. Students were throwing away uneaten fruit and barely opened plastic water bottles. What a shame to send all of that to the landfill every day.
One thing that we were surprised to learn during our eco audit was that these 15 students were completely zero waste with their lunch. We are inspired to encourage more of this at our school.
In order to encourage students to sort their own lunch waste, we will have a compost and recycling campaign the entire week of Earth Day.
Green Team will teach why, how, and what to compost. That Friday, the school will have a zero-waste lunch competition.
Green Team members will be the judges, and two classes will be announced winners. Each of those students will earn a book and blue bonnet seeds. Those classes will also plant a crepe myrtle tree together.
We would also like to purchase two composting tumblers to reuse our organic waste for the Hill Gardens.
Here's our projected budget.